Hello, good morning and a very warm welcome to you. I'm Rachel for Calkind TV, reporting live from Sydney. You're watching the Global Markets Roundup. Let's look at some key highlights and happenings from yesterday, starting with the US market. Benchmark US indices closed higher yesterday. That says stocks across all sectors, including financials, energy, healthcare and technology, moved higher after Omicron concerns waned. The S&P 500 rose 1.42%, while the Dow Jones surged 1.82%. The Nasdaq Composite was up 0.83%, and the small-cap Russell 2000 increased 2.74%. The World Health Organization said yesterday that the existing COVID vaccines might give some protection against the Omicron variant, although studies are to continue. Meanwhile, US officials hinted at tightening travel rules for foreign visitors. In addition, wearing a mask will be mandatory for all US travels. All 11 sectors of the S&P 500 stayed in positive territory. Financials, energy and industrial stocks were the top gainers, whereas healthcare, technology and consumer discretionary stocks also advanced. Well, now it's time for a very short break. Stay tuned. I'll be back with the UK and Australian market updates.
Hi there, James Preston for Calkind TV. Are you into gaming and virtual reality? Does AI and the endless possibilities it entails capture your interest? Or are you constantly trawling through the web to try and discover the latest updates and innovations in the tech space? Well, let us do the work for you. From the latest product launches to shocking affairs on the World Wide Web, exclusive interviews and information about the top companies like Apple and Google to brand new tech startups vying for your attention. Calkind's TechBeat has the latest in what matters in the world of technology. Join me every single Thursday on the TechBeat, exclusive to Calkind TV.
Welcome back. I'm Rachel and you're watching the Global Markets Roundup Show. European shares mostly ended lower as countries ramped up COVID-19 restrictions to limit the spread of the highly contagious new variant of the coronavirus. UK shares remained lackluster yesterday, with the domestic benchmark, the FTSE 100, oscillating in the negative region throughout the day. The 101 components heavily market index partly recovered the losses in the terminal deals, led by support from an upbeat Wall Street. The considerable upsurge in the heavyweight shares of Unilever, HSBC Holdings, Royal Dutch Shell, BP, Rio Tinto, the BHP Group, Reckitt Benckiser and the BT Group all supported the index. On the contrary, the moderate to larger drops in the blue chip components of Flutter Entertainment, Scottish Mortgage Investment Trust, Ashtead Group, Barclays, Lloyds Banking Group, the London Stock Exchange Group, Prudential, the National Grid, Glencore, British American Tobacco, GlaxoSmithKline and AstraZeneca counterbalance the cumulative positive points, steering the index into the red. The headline FTSE 100 lost 0.36% in the intraday session. The losses on the mid-cap heavy index FTSE 250 were larger, as the 250 share average declined 0.81%. The ASX 200 witnessed volatile trade this week, with the index closing lower for the second straight session yesterday, dropping 0.15%. Seven of the 11 sectors ended in the red, while the tech sector declined the most. The information technology sector was the biggest loser, with a 3.2% loss, followed by healthcare and materials, which ended 0.8% lower. Bucking the trend, utilities was the best performer with a 1.5% gain, followed by industrials, consumer discretionary and financials. US Treasury yields edged higher yesterday as investors priced in that Federal Reserve officials would accelerate the pace of its massive bond purchases, as signs of faster inflation appearing. Benchmark 100-year yields, their notes rose 1.446%, and the dollar index, which gauges the performance of the greenback, inched up 0.078%. The euro dropped 0.18%, while the yen traded higher by 0.34%. Oil prices settled higher in choppy trade overnight as concerns over looming supply glut eased. The market sentiment was also lifted after the Organization of the Petroleum Exported Countries and Allies decided to stick to plans to boost output slowly. Brent crude was up 80 cents. Well, the US crude futures rose 93 cents. Gold prices dropped overnight as demand for safe haven assets dropped following a rebound in the global equity market. The gold price slipped by more than 1% to hit a one-month low as investors reacted to the Fed's plans to tighten monetary policy, and US gold futures fell 1.2%. Well, that's all for now. Keep watching Kalkine TV for more market updates. I'm Rachel, signing off for now.